Hey you guys, this is Ruben React. So this is showing the top 5 of Junior Eurovision 2021, which was won by Armenia. So next is going to be in Armenia. Yay! I saw they already changed the logo. Look, they changed the logo with like nice colors. So I guess it's going to be the logo with those colors next year. Yeah, I'm going to show you the top 5. Okay, I understand that kids vote for that song, even though I found the dress made her look like she was trying to look like an adult, but I understand why it was in the top 5. Also, let me know if you think that the voting, that like people from other countries, because there was 199 people who voted from 199 countries, if that had an impact on the results or not, and you agree with the top 5, because I found the top 5 was correct, except for Azerbaijan was a big surprise for me, so I don't know why it wasn't so high in the top 5. This kid is just epic. I hope he's gonna be junior in a real Eurovision, and I hope he's gonna make videos and gonna continue, like, because he has something special. You have to look at my reaction to the video of Georgia, to his video. It's one of the videos that I have the most views of my videos after Armenia. So I don't know, I just love this video and this kid, and he's so natural. Like, nothing is like, it's not like somebody they force and they tell them, okay, do this, do that. No, he's doing it because he likes to do it. And yeah, I really love his performance and the way he's doing it. So I really was happy for him that he got fourth. I was expecting that. I was always saying in my videos, I'm sure he will be a surprise, because he's just, yeah, he's like a little Mika, you know, he's like, he's so fun. He's so much fun. And so much, so much real talent and so natural. By the way, I saw Dutch people responding to this, and they said that the TikTok, they stole it a little bit from the song that made Holland win in Eurovision. That he also, I don't remember his name, but he was giving the vote, and that he also said TikTok, and that the clock also, they use it in the performance, another performance. So the Dutch people were saying that it was a little bit stolen, but it had nothing to do with the song. Me, I was personal, this was one of my personal favorites, because first of all, the lyrics, because I speak French fluently, so the lyrics are epic, like really epic. And it's, if you don't understand the lyrics, I understand the song is not so captivating, but the lyrics are very good, and the song itself also. And because it was Junior Eurovision, I was even expecting this song to win. I know he won the jury votes, but I was even expecting him to win the whole thing. So, anyways, he did a great job, and I am a big fan of this song, and you should look my reaction also, it's very funny. Yeah. Before I start this, very deserved, she really deserved this, and I was even surprised it's also that she did not win. Like, I was like, between those three, I had no clue who was gonna win, but for the public vote, I thought personally that she was gonna win, because I thought, like, for Junior Eurovision, this was like a little bit more like the staging and everything, It was a bit more like something that kids and teenagers would like. So I was very surprised and personally very happy because personally I was a fan of Armenia that this song did not win. But and I also saw a lot of comments that some people were upset and they found that this song should have won. But I always say there can only be one winner, and in every Eurovision it's always a big controversy. Oh my God, my English. Controversy. I don't know how to say that word. Anyways, you can debate about it for years and years, but this is the result, and you have to accept it. And like French people say, c'est la vie, that's life. You cannot change it. Sorry. Just to let you know, somebody's waiting. Somebody's she was so good. She could have maybe. I'm thinking what she could have done better. Maybe her singing was not as good as it was in the video, or as good as it could have been. While she sang it very well. And also, guys, don't be upset for her because she's gonna have a great career. So, like, the one who wins doesn't always mean that their career is gonna be the best. It's like in the all performances. Look at Sergei Lazarev, for example, and all it's like everything. It's not always, but in this case, yes, she will have a big career, Maléna, because she already signed a big record label in the US, and she's just the best performer. So in this case, yes, she will. But the second person usually also has a very good career. And her, I'm sure she will have a very good career. So don't worry. She did very well. She was just unlucky that Maléna was there. Because, another year she would have won. And also, Poland already won twice. Keep in mind that, like, maybe that played a little part too. I don't know. In the end, Armenia, the real video and her performance, sorry to say, being objective, I guess, but it was just the best. The voice, the staging, I was just the most like impressed with everything. And the moment I saw it, I said, this is gonna win. So I was sure, but at the end I was having doubts because I was like, teenagers, kids, I'm happy that they do online votes because, like, otherwise kids and teenagers would spend a lot of money and this would not be good at all. So with that, I was very happy. And I'm happy that this is the result. And it's just a very good result for everybody, I think. Also, I can tell you guys a little secret. The videos which I have the most views on my reactions usually win. This was the case with Italy. You can watch in my Eurovision reaction videos. It had the most views by far. And Armenia too. So, it reflects the reality usually. And this song, it was just... I said it from the beginning. I was 100% sure that it was going to win. A lot of you guys had doubts and you told me, no, how can you be sure? I don't know. It was just a feeling. And also, I predicted it in 2019. I predicted it also in 2021 with the real Eurovision and with the junior. So, you know, just listen to what I say and shut the fuck up. No, I'm kidding. I'm happy with this. And her performance was outstanding. Like... It was like Vicky in 2019, just so prepared and everything until the smallest details. I'm sure they practice it for days and days and days, just like Poland and France. I'm not saying they did not practice the same, but you can just see that everything is very, very professional and that they have very good production behind it. So, and also they made the best video ever, like ever, ever. So, I mean, like, they made adult people get interested in Junior Eurovision also. So, and if you're honest, the best video, the best performance. And I'm happy that Junior Eurovision is getting, like, the attention it's getting now. It's 19 countries now. And I guess it's going to be more and more. I saw Noosh also say that, that she was saying, yeah, I'm sure they're going to get much more countries participating. Because as you notice, countries like Greece and Cyprus and the Scandinavian countries were not in this Junior Eurovision. And they, yeah, Junior Eurovision is kind of random usually. But this year was like a real Eurovision. Like for us Eurovision fans and like for us music artist fans, because I'm a reactor, we love this. We, for us, it was like a pre Eurovision. So like, yeah, epic. And yeah, that's all I'm going to say. I'm going to make reactions to the whole performances after this, but I just wanted to show you the top five. And yeah, so the Enzo, the friends won the jury votings, but the public votes was won by Armenia, and Poland second and France third. So no, France, I think they did not get so much points from the public, and I think that's why they did not get I think the third country that got the most points from the public was another country. I don't know which one. Let me think. I think it was Georgia. Yeah, I think so. Because they were fourth in the end. So, that's not a surprise, because I told you this guy is like such a small entertainer and everybody's going to be like hypnotized by him. And it was the case. He's just very, very captivating and very funny. And I was just very happy that he got rewarded for that by the public. So yeah, everything went the way that Ruben liked. So yeah, and in France, you know, Barbara Pravi was there. She made a performance. Again, I can respond to that too. I think I will do that, because my first reaction to Barbara Pravi was this, with this shirt. So I can do like a kind of remake. And yeah, I find that she's a legend. She's a real legend. She wrote the song Bim Bam Toi, which is one of the biggest songs ever made for Junior Eurovision, because it's even in Fortnite. So can you imagine? And also, it's the most streamed song ever, I think, for Junior Eurovision. Or one of the most streamed. Yeah, I think it's the most streamed. And then she wrote also the winner for last year from J'imagine. So, and then she also participated herself and she became second. If Italy was not there, she would have won. So she's a legend, and Barbara's gonna be making a lot of music and changing the music industry in France, which is epic, because yeah, that's what we need. Also, Barbara, if you're watching, hey, I hope you're also happy with the results. I think she is. Maybe she's a bit sad that sorry for my English, that France did not win. I don't know how much she was involved, if she was as much involved in the process as she was when she wrote those two songs, the two previous years. But I guess she was involved in some ways, because she was also having a performance. So I hope you're happy, Barbara. And also thank you for performing, and that your performance was amazing. It was tip top. So tip top tip. And so I'm gonna make a reaction to that after this, and also a reaction to the winning performance. And I can also make a reaction to Poland and to France. So like the top three or the top four countries, Georgia too, because that's my personal favorite, one of my personal favorites also. So that's all going to be for me for the top five and the just talking about Eurovision and what happened. Wishing you guys a great day. Don't forget to be yourself, be nice to yourself and each other, and always be yourself. Subscribe, comments, Like. And that's all gonna be for me. Okay, doodoo, ciao, ciao, au revoir. And what was that word that we were singing in the song from Armenia? Kami, kami, na, 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 na. Vahenum. Yeah, that's my favorite word. Check out my reaction to Armenia if you did not see it. It's one of my best reactions. And it's also just like an epic song. And yeah, I'm just happy that she won. So see you guys next video. And that's all going to be for now. Okay, doo doo, ciao, ciao. Au revoir.